This is KNEB.TV weather from the KNEB Storm Center, your trusted source for weather.
We're going to be cooling off conditions, thankfully. That's about all that we could say. 93 as we go here through the next couple hours. We'll stay in the 90s, dipping down into the low 60s tomorrow. Not quite as hot tomorrow as what it was today, but that's splitting hairs. Stray late day storm is going to be possible tomorrow. We'll turn hot again on Sunday, and really mainly dry conditions are going to continue for most of the next 7 days. 95 yesterday after a morning low of 59, and unfortunately still nothing in the rain gauge, just a trace of precip so far is all we've had for the month. Now as we look at today, yes, it was hot. Look at some of these unofficial high temperatures today. 103, that tied a record high in Scotts Bluff at 103 degrees. 103 in Chadron, 100 in Gordon, 101 in Sydney, 100 in Torrington today as well. So very hot conditions. If you didn't hit the century mark, it was still plenty warm with upper 90s all the way around. These temps are not going to be as hot tomorrow, but they'll be back pretty close to that as we go into Sunday. Right now, still at 101 in Scotts Bluff, 99 right now in Sterling. Very hot conditions here across the region, and over 100 still in Chadron, Torrington as well. 96 in Ogallala, upper 90s here for all of us as it's been very hot. And winds are coming out of the south, out in the central portions of the state, but more northerly and northwesterly here in the panhandle. But that's not really helping cool things down at all. Severe weather threat well to our north and east tonight. We're going to stay dry. Now tomorrow, the Storm Prediction Center putting out this slight risk of severe storms, and I think this area looks pretty good for this chance of some severe storms to the east of the panhandle in the central portions of the state. We have a marginal risk back here in our area simply because it's not going to be very many storms. They'll be very isolated, but if we do see one tomorrow, they could turn strong to severe by Sunday. That gets pushed well off to our north and east. Nothing really happening tonight, just hot conditions, maybe a stray shower or storm in the northern sand hills. That's it. Not going to cool off a whole lot tonight either. Temperatures down to around 60 degrees. Now for tomorrow, we're going to start the day with sunshine, and it's going to get warm again. Still hot, but not as hot as today. And then we start to bring in those late day storms. You see forecast modeling pushing most of it off to the east of us, and then it quickly exits. So tomorrow afternoon and evening, I think instead of seeing storms develop in the high country, they're going to develop in our area and quickly push and get more organized in central portions of Nebraska. Highs tomorrow going to be still pretty warm, but you can see those deep purple colors just off to our south and east. We're still going to be, though, in the upper 80s and low 90s here for the area. And rain threats going to be confined to the sand hills, but they could be pretty decent amounts at a half to an inch of rain in some of those areas. Hopefully they get that. It'd be nice to spread that around into some of these other areas that have been dry of late. Mainly clear, quiet tonight, 61 for a low. For tomorrow, we're going to be dealing with 92 degrees, not as hot. Again, just a stray thunderstorm, about a 20% chance of those in the afternoon. But if they develop, they will have the chance to turn strong to severe here in the region. We heat back up for Sunday. Look at that, back to near 100 again. Monday, we drop about 10 degrees off of that into the upper 80s. Then right back into the mid upper 90s, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday of next week, as hot conditions return here to the region.